गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. डियर स्टूडेंट, इन योर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैड डिस्कस अबाउट ऑफ द लीनियर इक्वेशन एंड वी ऑल्सो सॉल्व द एक्सरसाइज 9A. इन दिस क्लास वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ऑफ द सिस्टमेटिक मेथड ऑफ फॉर सॉल्विंग एन इक्वेशन एंड वी विल सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन ऑफ द एक्सरसाइज 9B. सो टू सॉल्व एन इक्वेशन वी विल फॉलो द सम स्टेप्स आर सम रूल्स. इन दिस रूल we know that an equation which is the balance in the both side, which is the balance as a balance in the both side, if you want to keep a things to balance, you will take the both side equal things, you will take the both side equal things. So we will follow the sum rules. That is, first is we can add the same number to the both side of an equation. Second, if we can add, then we can also subtract. We can subtract the same number from the equation. Third, we can also multiply. We can multiply both the side of an equation by the same non-zero number. And fourth, we can divide the both side by same non-zero numbers. So with help of these four rules, we will solve an equation. We will solve a linear equation or an algebraic equation. We can add, we can subtract, we can multiply, or we can divide by the same non-zero number. So with help of this, there are one more method is given to solving an equation. That is the base of this fundamental equation rules of the equation solving an equation. That rules is called the transposition. This is the method to solve an equation. In the transposition, when you change the when we transfer a term from LHS to RHS or RHS to LHS, we change the sign of terms. If any positive terms, we transfer it to the right side, that will be negative. Suppose x minus 3 is equal to 2x plus
minus 5. It is. So we when we transferred 2x on the left hand side and 3 on the right hand side, that will give the x. Here is 2x is the positive, that is minus 2x. And here minus 5 equal to minus 5. When we transfer the minus 3 on right hand side, that will give the plus. So minus x is equal to minus 2. Now we multiply by minus 1, that is x is equal to 2. Okay. So in the transposition, when we transfer a term from left hand side to right hand side or right hand side to left hand side, we change the sign of the terms. Okay. You note it. Okay, now we come on the exercise, that is exercise 9B. In the exercise 9B, the question is given as, solve each of the following equations and verify the answer in each case. You will verify the answer also. So in the first question, that is given as x plus 5 is equal to 12. Yet in to solve an equation, we will make the separate variable in the one side and constant terms in the another side. Then we make variable as separate. There will be no multi factor, there will be no coefficient of the variable. So we will make it single. We will make the x single. Here x is with the 5. What is the 5? 5 is added here. So when we subtract 5 from both sides, when we subtract 5 in both sides, that is x plus 5 minus 5 is equal to 12 minus 5. You know that we can subtract. We can subtract a same number in both sides. So here the 5 is cancelled by 5. So that is x is equal to 7. This is the value of the given variable. This is the solution of the equation. Now check. Put x is equal to 7 in given equation. That is first LHS x plus 5, that is 7 plus 5, it is 12. And RHS is already 12. Here LHS is equal to RHS. So it verify. So it verify. You can solve second, third, fourth, fifth, we will solve the question number 5th. In the question number 5th, 3x minus 5 is equal to 13. Okay. Here we use the transposing method. We know that in the transposing method, when any term transfer from one side to another side, their sign will be changed. Now, we can write it 3x is equal to 13 plus 5. Minus 5 to RHS, that is 3x is equal to 18, then x is equal to 6, dividing both sides by 3. So now we can check, put x is equal to 6 in both side of equation, in both sides, then you get the LHS 3x minus 5, 3 into 6 minus 5, that is 18 minus 5, it will be 13. And RHS is already 13, here LHS is equal to RHS, so it verified. So it verify, okay? You note it. Okay. Now we will solve the question number 8. 6, 7, you can solve that. In the question number 8, 3x upon 5 is equal to 15. Here 3x is equal to 5. When you multiply it, that is 3x is equal to 75. Now x is equal to 75 upon 3, dividing both sides by 3, that is x is equal to 25. Now we check, put x is equal to 25 in equation, that is 3 into 25 upon 5 and RHS is equal to 15. Here LHS is equal to RHS, so it verify. Now we will solve the question number 9. First you note it. Now we solve the question number 9. The question number 9. Five x minus 3 equal to x plus 17. Here we will solve it by the transposing method. In the transposing method, we can write 5x. When you transfer the x on the left hand side, here is the positive x plus x, then it will minus x, and here the 70. Now we transfer the minus 3 on the right hand side, that will be plus 3. Here you write that transposing x to LHS and 3 to RHS. Now you will, this is the like term, then you can simple it, that is 4x, and when you add it, that is give the 20. So x is equal to 20 upon 4. What we do here, we dividing by 4. That is x is equal to 5. Now we will check. When you check that, put x is equal to 5 in RHS and LHS. When you put x is equal to 5 in the RHS and LHS, when first we take LHS, 5x minus 3, that is 5 into 5 minus 3. It is 25 minus 3, it is 22, and RHS x plus 17, that is 5 plus 17, it is 22. Here LHS is equal to RHS, show it verify. To verify, we will put the value of x in the both side, and then we solve that. If the both sides are equal, then it will be verified. If the both sides are not equal, then it will be not verified. You note it. Okay, now we solve the question number 14. In the question number 14, x by 2 is equal to 1. First, we transfer the x by 2 minus x by 3 is equal to 1. What we do here? Transposing x by 3 to LHS. Okay? When we solve it, that is give 3x minus 2x upon 6 is equal to 1, that is x upon 6 is equal to 1, that is x is equal to 6. X is equal to 6. What we do here? Multiplying. By 6 in both sides. Okay. When you find the x is equal to 6, then you can check it. When you check, put x is equal to 6 in LHS and RHS. Here the LHS is equal to x by 2. That is 6 by 2, it is equal to 3, and RHS is equal to x by 3 plus 1, it will be equal to 6 by 3 plus 1, it will give the 3. Here LHS is equal to RHS, so it verify. Okay, so you note it. Okay, now we solve the question number 19. In the question number, we can take the question number 18 as a 15, 16, 17 and 19 and 20, that is same as the 18. So we solve the question number 18. In the question number 18, 16, 3x minus 5 minus 10, 4x minus 8 is equal to 40. First you open the bracket by the Bodmer's rule. We will remove the bracket. When you remove the bracket, it is give the 16, 3 is 48, x minus 80 minus 40x plus 80 is equal to 40. Where the 80 is cancelled by 80, 48 minus 40, that is give the 8x is equal to 40. This implies x is equal to 40 upon 8, it will give the 5. So x is equal to 5. Now check, we will check the put x is equal to 5 in LHS and RHS. So, when we put the x is equal to 5 in the LHS and RHS, the LHS is equal to given as 16 in the bracket 3x minus 5, that is 16 into 3 into 5 minus 5, this will be 16 into 15 minus 5, that is 16 into 10, it is 160. And when we put the value of x in the RHS, that is, RHS is given as, whole is the LHS. In the LHS, 16, 3x minus 5 minus 10, 4x minus 8. When you put the value 16 into 3 into 5 minus 5, minus 10, 4 into 5 minus 8, when you simple it, that is 16 into 10 minus 10 into 12, that is 160 minus 120, it is 40. And RHS is equal to 40. Here, LHS is equal to RHS, show it verified. So it verified.
You note it. Okay, now we take the question number 21. In the question number 21, there is a denominator part of the given in the equation. So if any equation which is in the denominator part of the given, so first we multiply the given whole equation of both side of the equation by the LCM of the denominator. So first we take the first as a 21, n upon 5, n upon 4 minus 5 is equal to n upon 6 plus 1 upon 2. Here is the denominator part, we can write as 5 upon 1, we can write it. Now we will multiply the LCM, we multiply by the LCM of 4, 6 and 2, that is 12. When we multiply by 12, we multiplying by the LCM of 4, 6 and 2, that will be the 12. So multiplying by 12, that is 12 into n by 4 minus 5 upon 1 into 12 is equal to n upon 6 into 12 plus 1 upon 2 into 12. Your first work will be, you will multiplying each terms by the LCM of the denominator. If any equation there are denominator part is given that, then we make two simple, we multiplying by the LCM. When you multiplying, that is 4, 3 is 12, 6, 2 is 12, 2, 6 is 12. Now you simple it, that is 3n minus 60 is equal to 2n plus 6. Now you transferred it, when you transposing, that is 3n minus 2n is equal to 6 plus 16, that is n is equal to 66. Now you can check it by to check n upon 4 minus 5, this is the LHS, that is 66 upon 4 minus 5. When you simple it, 66 minus 20 upon 4, that is 44 upon 4, it is 11. And RHS, n by 6 plus 1 by 2, that is 66 upon 6 plus 1 by 2, there is some mistake, that is 66. Here LHS is equal to RHS, show it verify. Okay student, so in today's class we had completed the exercise 9b. There are some more question is given in which the equation denominator is given there. So to solve the denominator, that type of the question, we will multiply by the LCM of the denominator of each terms, then we multiply
and then we solve that. Okay, so student, in today's class we had completed the exercise 9B. Okay, thank you, good day.